Close the door.
Yep. Yeah, hi, I believe so we will be doing sums today. Today is the day 2 of the 21 day workshop of Quant that we are planning to do. We will be taking up a few questions every day and trying to solve. So let's try to go about it. The idea behind this whole thing is, as I said, it's creating a habit. That is what is more important. So we are talking about creating a habit. So we are what we do repeatedly, and that's what the idea behind creating the video is. So as mentioned previously, so we are what we repeatedly do, and when you create a habit, you will be able to do well in the examination. Okay, so let's continue with the sums and see how we do we go about it. Taking first sum. Try solving this. Once you try solving it, then I will try to look at the approach of how to go about solving things faster. I can't, you may not be able to see me because of some network issue, but yes, maybe from tomorrow onwards I will try to make a provision of the video where you can maybe able to see me as and when I am taking a lecture. But anyway, try to solve it and then maybe I will try to give a solution. I will start maybe directly with the first sum out here. Now, Piyush paid 400 rupees for a normal working hours of 30 per week. So you are working for 30 weeks per week and you are paid rupees 400, and then for working beyond that and beyond this 30 hours, if I'm going to work, I'll be paid per hour 1/4 more. That means if he's being paid 400 for 30 hours, he is going to be paid 1/4 more. 1/4 more will be 100 rupees, which is 500 for 30 hours. Okay, so 400 more for 30 hours. Now for overtime, this is normal time, overtime is 500 per 30 hours. If he has to earn 500, now he has to earn total of 500. He is already earning 400 in normal hours, which means he wants to earn 100 rupees extra. Okay, he is already earning 400 in normal time of 30 hours. He has to earn 100 rupees extra. So 500 takes 30 hours. For 100 extra, how much he has to work? Okay, he gets 500 rupees for working 30 hours. This is overtime, remember that. Overtime. So 100, how much he has to work? If you cross multiply, you get 30 upon 5, which is 6 hours. That means in a week, he should work 30 hours plus 6 hours, which is 36 hours. Normally, in most of the sums that come in the exam, you don't require too complicated equations, etc. If you just try to solve it logically, it becomes much, much faster to solve. And yes, directly proportional, inversely proportional are very important concepts to be used when you're solving the sums as far as exam is concerned. So again, I repeat out here, normally he is paid 400 rupees for 30 hours. And he is paid one-fourth more. Okay, he is paid one-fourth more, that is 100 rupees more. That is 500 rupees paid for 30 hours during his overtime. Now to get a total of 500, he is already getting 400. He needs to get 100 extra for overtime. Right? So he gets 500 for 30 hours to get 100 extra. How many hours? You will realize he has to work for 6 hours extra. So total time is 36 hours. Not difficult. If you just understand and try to work on putting the data properly, you should be able to get the answer immediately. If you put equations, maybe it will take a longer time. Well, let's go to the next question. Try to solve and then maybe we will discuss how to go about solving this. You can always communicate with me on chat. I can see your chat. So if anything that you want to communicate, you can definitely do that. And I should be able to see this. Video is not working because I moved to another place and my video settings are not done. And therefore video was not working. But otherwise, you can always communicate with me on chat. And if you're getting the answer, you can reply. If you want to communicate to me on chat, you can go about doing it. There are two approaches of solving this. Okay, one and the easy approach maybe is using the options. So if I use the option, it's, for example, if I use 9 plus 1 10 10 is not a factor of 144, so I can directly rule out A option. Okay, now coming to 7 7 plus 1 8, if I take 7 as A, so 8, 1 plus A becomes 8 into B plus C. So 8 into how much is 144? Divide 144 by 8. You will get 6. So 8 ones are 64 is what you get. So 18. So if you look at 18 plus 7 doesn't give you 29, so not possible. 18 plus 7, because A will become 7, so 18 plus 7 doesn't give you 25, so not possible. Let's take 11. So if I take 11, this becomes 12 into 12 144, but 12 plus 1 13 doesn't give you again. And take 5 5 plus 1 6, 6 into, if you divide, it becomes 24. 6 into 24 is 144, and you realize that B plus C is 24, 1 plus A is 6, so A becomes 5, B plus C becomes 24, and the addition is 29, the option straight away. So easily use options and try to get the answer in this case. So I'll just use the options and just substitute, very simple and simple other way. Next way to do about is, look at the sum. If you look at sum is 1 plus A plus B plus C is 144. Sorry, not 144. The sum of multiplication is 1 plus A plus B plus C. Now 1 Now I know A plus B plus C is 29, so 29 plus 1 gives you 30. That means sum of these two multiplication is 30. Now break up 144 and see what are the ways you get. You get 12, 12 is 144, but 12 plus 12 is 24, not 30, not possible. You have 18, 8 is 144, but 18 plus 8 is 26, not this. You have 24, 6 is 144, but 24, 6 is 30, satisfies. So automatically I can make out that A can be either 23 or 5, either of the two. A can be either 23 or 5. Since 5 is the end option, you can use that to get the answer. So either of the two methods is fine. Using the options is always a good way to get the answer. Try to use options wherever possible. Yeah, look at this sum and try to solve. So let me explain this sum. It basically says here's one huge pile first. So when you say you're breaking it up into a smaller pile, that means one pile is broken up into two piles. That means you get from one it has gone to two, so you become plus one piles. And when you break it up into three piles, so one it becomes three, that means you get plus two extra piles. So here you get plus one extra pile, you get plus two extra pile. So that means when you do two, you get plus one extra pile. When you do 3, you get plus 2 extra pile. When you do 3, you get plus 2, plus 3 and so on. So I want to go to 42 piles. That means from 1, I have to go to 42. Which means I want 41 extra piles. So let's look at A option. I mean A option definitely. If I just do plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, I can get 41. Right? Or I can do plus 2 20 times and plus 1 1 time. I'll get plus 41 to get me 42 piles. I'll repeat again. When you have one pile and you want to break it up into two piles, so one pile becomes two piles, so you get one extra pile. In the second case, when you put one to make it three, so one pile it goes to three piles, so it becomes plus two, and so on. So if you look at the A option, it's plus one and plus two. So basically, I want to go from 1 to 42, means basically I want plus 41. Which is possible in many ways. So I can do plus 2 into 20 and plus 1 into 1 to get plus 40. So A it's possible, but I have to find out what is not possible. Number, I want to find out what is not possible. Let's go to B option just for understanding sake. B is plus 2 and plus 3. Can I get 41 with plus 2 and plus 3? Yes, I can get plus 2 into 18 and or 19. And plus 3 into 1, that will also give me plus 41. So 3 and 4 is also possible. If I take 3 and 5, plus 2 and plus 4. Plus 2 and plus 4 will never give me plus 41, because plus 2 and plus 4 are both even numbers and plus 41 is odd number. You can't get plus 2 and plus 4 to get plus 41, not possible. So answer will be C option. You can't get plus 2 and plus 4 to get plus 41. Because plus 2 plus 4 is both even, so how much ever you add them, it will always be even. You can't get plus 41, C option. It is tough to get, but more logical in nature, even odd number concepts. Even odd number concepts are also very important in the examination. It is asked subtly, and that could be a method of solving it faster. Right, let's look at next sum, geometry. Anyone want to communicate with me through chat, you can do so. I can basically, I think I can see the chat. I don't know. I have not seen anyone's chat till now. But anyone who wants to communicate with me can comment. Or I may not be able to see anyone's comment because of some reason. Okay, coming to this sum, PQ addresses 4 points in a circle with center O. SQ and PR are diameters. The radius circle is 6. Find the area of triangle PRS. Whenever I have a diameter and a point on a circle, I always imagine to be a right angle triangle. PRS. Because a diameter always subtends a right angle at any point on a circle. Okay, a diameter always subtends a right angle at any point of a circle. So which means if this is 120, this will be 60. If this is 60, these two lengths are equal. You can make out that this is a equilateral triangle. So we know radius is 6. If this is 6, this also will be 6 length. Okay, this length is 6, this length is 6. Okay, this whole length is, and this is 60 degree angle. So this whole triangle is a 30, 60, 90 angle. If you look at PRS, is a 30, 60, 90 triangle. You should always be aware about this 30, 60, 90 triangle and triplets and 45, 45, 90 triangle. 45, 45, 90 triangle and triplets. Normally in the exams, one of these concepts will come whenever it's a right angle triangle. So moment you know that, you know this is 6 and this will be 6 root 3, because in 30, 60, 90 angle, if side over 30 is x, side over 60 will be x root 3. So automatically you get the area as half into 6 root 3, which will be 18 root 3, 8 option. You will get the area as half into 6 root 3, which will be 18 root 3, which will be A option. Okay. Last sum for a day. Just try to understand that and then maybe I'll try to explain how to solve it. I somehow feel that the chat is not working because I'm getting the same number of live learners out here, so nothing is changing. So I'm assuming that my chat is not working, but anyway, even if I can't communicate chat, hopefully I'll be able to rectify tomorrow. Okay, let's try to understand and solve it. So you have pizza broken up into 5 parts of different sizes. Let's say one small, one slightly big, 3, say one very small and 5. So 5 parts. I'm just saying 5 different sizes. That's what I'm trying to draw. Okay, each one had. So the smallest pizza can be had by P person, let's say. And I distribute. Same as the smallest person pizza can be had by Q and the smallest pizza can be had by R. So the number of ways which I get the smallest pizza for P will be same as number of ways I get smallest pizza for Q and same as number of ways for smallest pizza as R. So since all these three ways will be same, let's say x, 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 my total has to be 3x or a multiple of 3. And if you look at the option, there's only one multiple of 3, 30, even directly mark the answer B option. And this is one way of trying to get shortcuts and trying to figure out how. Multiples are a very good way of trying to get the answer. Okay, but we'll look at how to solve it. But I'm just trying to give you a hint as to what to do. Right? So if you look at it, one small pizza P. Okay? And from that P, if you have X number of ways, so Q and R will also have X and X number of ways. So total will be 3X ways, which is multiple of 3. Okay, now coming to number of ways if this is P. They said two edges cannot be P. So So let's say only one P gets only one pizza. So Q and RB get two pizzas. In which case, you can have maybe Q here, R here, these two, and vice versa. So P having one pizza, there are two ways basically. So Q and R alternate two ways. Now P having two pizzas. If P has to be, say, one here, this can be Q and R two ways, and this also will be, one will be Q, one will be R, two ways. So four ways, P two, four ways out here, and same with P here. Look, P can be either here or here, both same ways. If P is here, it will be four ways. P will be here, it will be four ways. So total will be 10 ways with P. Okay, repeat again. P only one, the four can be arranged with Q and R alternatively with two ways. If P is two, that means P can be, the second one can be here or second one can be this side. So if P is here, Q and R two ways out here, Q and R two ways out, four ways. Same with P on the other side also, four ways. So total 10 ways with P having the smallest pizza. So this is 10, this is also 10, this is also 10. So total will be 30. So automatically B option will be the answer. Right, I hope it's clear. Right, so I wind up the session today. I think there was some technicality.